Thank everybody for coming down to the mansion tonight and making this such a memorable day for Joe and Nora. You know, as father of the bride, that sounds really cool. As father of the bride and as your godfather, I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge that my day personally has been interrupted several times. I've had to go upstairs to the office here at the mansion and listen to requests for favors from several guests here. Sylvia needed me to straighten out the principal of our middle school out in Seattle. Uncle Leo again needed me to intervene with the Denville Farmers Market that he could play his music. Uncle Greg needed my financial backing for his March Madness that he's mixed up in. I made him an offer they couldn't refuse. If there's nothing else, I'd like to go to my daughter's wedding. But as my father, my late father would have said, here we are, just like we planned. And first off, I want to give a salute to the Oregonian newlyweds, Nora, my favorite daughter, and Joe, now my favorite son-in-law. They, in the spring, have sprung. In my first draft of the speech, I was going to give a shout-out to Mother Nature for blessing us with a beautiful sunny day, but the fickle gal let us down. No matter, we will party on. but taking a dramatic pause right here. But you know, this mansion here is beautiful. Nestled in the beautiful Rockaway countryside, intimate old world charm, breathtaking views of the lake. It's got that certain savoir faire they talk about. And it's 12 minutes from Andrea Drive, so as I'm paying the bill here, I was sold on that. But savoir faire aside, I know I don't know this for a fact, but I'm pretty sure it's true that if Nora and Joe had their druthers, they'd be getting married in June in Tennessee at the legendary Bonnaroo Music Festival. Miss all the muck and mire and general debauchery that event is known for. I also don't know this for a fact, but I'm pretty sure it's true that Mrs. Dennehy, who is his live and let live as they come, just might have exercised her mother of the bride veto and shot that idea down. We'll never know. Now, as father of the bride, I always had in my mind that Nora was going to get married at center court of the Field of Dreams as part of a deluxe opening ceremony of the festival that they've had been. Now, you guys know me. I've actually kind of scripted this out. It's a beautiful July afternoon. It always is. The backyard is packed. People are dressed to the nines. It's going to be the wedding of the century, at least in Rockaway. I'm coming down the red carpet, the beautiful Nora at my side, flanked by an honor guard of badminton bracket-carrying fellows and gals. It's just looking tremendous. Until it's not. Until the proceedings are hijacked by a villain figure, fill in the blank, Vladimir Putin, the Joker. It looks like we're doomed. But then, out of the distance, we hear a rumble. It's a loud sound. Is it a bird? No, much louder than a bird. Is it a plane? No, not quite as loud as a plane. No, hovering above the backyard is a helicopter. Not just any helicopter. It's a firefighting helicopter. Propelling out of the chopper is a heroic young man, underfoot, to save the day and save the damsel in distress, Joe Kendall.
Yeah, Joe.
I'm pretty sure Mrs. Dennehy would have vetoed that idea. I'm pretty sure Joe's mom would have vetoed that idea. All right, but look, today is not about my cockamamie badminton script ideas. It's about celebrating a Jersey girl and a guy from Virginia who met in college in San Diego, who now make their home in the beautiful Rogue River Valley of Southwest Oregon. Home, I mean farmstead. They're actually young farmers. I think of the famous painting by Grant Wood, the American Gothic, Joe, stoic look, pitchfork in hand, his pensive wife Nora by his side, maybe worrying about the baby goats or next year's crop. Don't worry, guys, you've got this. You know, Joe and Nora are a great couple, and I don't mean in some superficial, shallow episode of The Bachelor kind of way. I mean it sincerely. They're both loving, caring, smart, loving, folks, you must have very good parents. But I know I speak for everybody here and wishing them health and happiness, and that their first child, I hope I don't get canceled for this, their first child be a masculine child. Joe and Nora, I love you very much. Joe and Nora.
Thank you so much, Chris. Amazing. Don't go anywhere, Chris. It is now time to dance with your daughter.
Not unexpected. Not unexpected.
Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. Yes, you're lovely with your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you and the way you look tonight.
Joe, you're next. Would you please find mom?